See, I'm a stand-up comedian. My father was a glass technologist, and my mother was very fucking happy with this arrangement. And you know what I mean? And she did nothing for 20 fucking years. You know what I mean? She was one of these housewives. Do you remember? No, it's not like a porn connotation. Just a thing people did. Housewife. You know? Yeah, lads. And sorry, ladies. But a kitchen warrior. kitchen warrior. You know. She was a housewife, and because back in the 60s and 70s, you couldn't be a house husband. You know, if you were a bloke, you stay in the house, you were a layabout, you know, or a scouser. Housewives from 1961, which was about 1981, when all of a sudden reality kicked in. My dad got me redundant and she had to get a job at a dart shop in the Green Market. This is proper fucking Ken Loach stuff, this, isn't it? Now, it's real life Ken Loach, you know? But no. And she got a job, and because for years, you see, I used to look at my mother, I used to think, fuck you, fucking look at you, man. You do nothing. It's fucking great. No, don't get me wrong, she's got the world by the bollocks. It's fantastic. Don't worry about that. Eh? I used to think, God, when I was a kid, I thought I'd love to be a woman. Not in a chop your genitals off and blame the world type way like they are now. But no, what I mean is, we'll cut that bit out. No, just the idea, look at you, man, you do fuck all. You know what I mean? She used to, because me and my sister used to have to go to a place called school, do you remember that? Oh, terrible, you know? Good holidays, but oh, it was hard, you know? And me dad used to work at Lemon Glass Works. I didn't see him in the morning. He used to go out in the morning, come back at night, and then he'd come back at 6 o'clock at night, and he was tired, you know? And he didn't speak much. He just watched the telly and smoke, you know, and drink a bit. He didn't have much of his social life. And, you know, just occasionally speak, you know, just occasionally, you're watching a sitcom or something. Are you being served? He just occasionally just go, the puff's funny. The puffs. I like the puff. The puff's funny, and that's all I got out of him all week. You know, I didn't know what kind of bloke he was. Just apparently, like gay men. That's all it was. It's just confusing. You know what I mean? And he'd even get rang up at the weekends. At the weekends, you come in the weekends, and they'd ring up. They're going, oh, Harry, the fitter would ring up with the engineer. Harry, the furnace has gone out. He's like, don't worry about it. I'll get myself over. Or they'd ring up, Harry, I've lost my pencil. Don't worry about that. I'll go and sort your pencil out, you know, because that's why British industry went down the pan, because people were shit. Let's just get it. Let's not dress it up in any way. You know, you get, oh, do you know what killed British industry? It was the bloody Tories. And then other people say, no, it wasn't. It was unions. It wasn't. It was just the people involved were all shite. That's all it was. Don't let them fucking kid you on otherwise. You know what I mean? Eh? British car industry. Oh, who's to blame for that? Was it Margaret Thatcher? Was it Keith Joseph? No. Oh, it was the union men, was it? Oh, it was Len Murray. No, it wasn't. It was the fucking Austin Allegro. That's what it was. You know what I mean? Eh? You blame that fucker. Eh? Driving out the forecourt, it's fucking rusting already. Oh, don't worry, it does 27 miles the fucking gallon. You know what I mean? It's no wonder we're fucking lost.